This video is sponsored by Surfshark. Like a lot of people, one of the main reasons I'm drawn to a tablet is, you know, for the nice big screen. When I'm working off my phone, because it's relatively small, I don't expect to use more than one or maybe two apps at a time. Now, with the larger workspace on tablets though, it's not that crazy to expect better productivity. Today, I wanted to do a comparison between these two to see what they have to offer in terms of multitasking, aka how they handle running more than one app at a time. Okay, let's start with the basics. Both tablets can of course run two apps side by side. On the iPad, there's a few ways to quickly get this done. You can drag a second app from the dock, like this. You can hit the shortcut at the top, then select your second app from the home screen. From the app switcher, you can drag one app right on top of another. And as a bonus, for those of you who have a keyboard paired, you can search an app with Spotlight and then just drag it into place like this. On the Galaxy tab, there's a few ways you can do this as well. You can drag a second app from the Apps Edge panel here and drag it into place like this. From the Reasons menu, you can tap the app icon, hit open in split screen, and pick your second app. If you use certain apps in split view all the time, you can also save them as an app pair, then quickly launch them right from the app's edge panel like so. On the iPad, you can choose between the normal 50-50 split or a 3/4 split on either side. To swap positions, all it takes is a quick swipe on the three dots in the direction you want it to move, just like this. You can also swap the apps in the app switcher menu, which is a really nice touch. On the tab, you get a little more freedom in terms of sizing. It doesn't snap to an automatic split, so you can actually choose the exact split you want for each app. To swap positions, just tap the three dots in the middle and hit the swap icon, just like that. You could also long press the small bar at the top of each app and drag it across to the other side. But I personally don't do it this way because the bar itself is kind of hard to grab and the animations can get a little choppy at times. In split view mode, while the iPad will only allow two apps, Samsung actually gives you the option to split the right side in half to squeeze in a third app. It's definitely a little cramped, as you can see, but totally usable if you absolutely need to keep an eye on three apps at the same time. On top of split view, both tablets can run apps in a pop-up as well. Samsung calls it pop-up view, while Apple calls it slide over. On the tab, you can put an app into a pop-up view by dragging it from the app's edge panel and dropping it into the center of the screen, or just select the option from the Reasons menu. Once in a pop-up, you have the freedom to resize the window, move it around, change the transparency, or minimize it into a floating icon. You can open as many pop-up windows as you want. Going back to the home screen minimizes them all into this nice, neat stack that you can quickly reopen as needed. On the iPad, to open an app and slide over, just select it from the three-dot menu at the top. You can also drag an app from the dock and drop it on top of whatever app you have open. If you're already in split view, you'll have to drop it right between the two apps, just like this. Once open, you can actually hide the app by sliding it off to the side. To bring it back, just swipe inwards from that side. The slide over window can be placed on either side and also hidden on either side. Any apps you put into slide over mode will stack on top of each other, and you can quickly cycle between them by swiping right or left on this mini navigation bar. If that's too slow, you can quickly jump to an app by swiping up on that same bar and selecting the exact app you want. Something I appreciate is that if you go to the app switcher, you'll notice that all your slide over windows are laid out to the right. And just like these other app previews, you can drop them into split window modes right from here too. While both tablets will let you run multiple instances of the same app, I found that there are more apps that support it on the iPad. One of the more popular use cases would be to run multiple instances of something like Microsoft Word, which although can be done with a workaround on the Galaxy tab, it isn't officially supported. iPadOS also puts more effort to help you stay on top of all the instances of each app that you have open. So for example, I have three instances of Word open right now, as you can see, and if I want to open another one, It's as simple as pressing this plus icon right here. I mean, if you're the type of person that uses one app at a time, none of this really matters to you, right? But we're talking multitasking here. So if you're constantly switching or rearranging apps throughout the day, I gotta give the edge to the iPad for how well thought out and fluid the multitasking UI is overall. Now, the Galaxy Tab punches back with a feature called DeX. If you've never heard of DeX, basically you hit a shortcut and it changes the tablet UI into a desktop-like one that's meant to be paired with a keyboard and mouse. You've got a taskbar at the bottom that displays apps you have open, notifications, and a bunch of other stuff. Apps will open in resizable windows that you can move around and snap to the edges just like a real computer. Before you get too excited, keep in mind that it's still running Android apps. The only thing that's changed is how everything is laid out. But still, if you're used to working off a computer and enjoy that computer-styled workflow, this is multitasking that you'll feel right at home with and appreciate. External monitor support is possible on both, but because of DeX, the Galaxy Tab does a better job here. You can have the tablet launch DeX on the monitor while keeping the Galaxy Tab itself in tablet mode. Pair a keyboard plus mouse, and you have a very basic computer setup. If you wanted to, you could even use the entire tablet as a massive trackpad. It's kind of wild that Samsung even thought of this. The iPad Pro can only do screen mirroring on the extra display, but because monitors are typically 16:9, you're stuck with these black bars on either side. Apple probably doesn't want you to use the iPad like this anyways. They want you to interact with it using touch or the Apple Pencil, because honestly, that's where the iPads really shine anyways. Not everyone will care, but if you're like me and use drag and drop all the time, hands down, the iPad is on another level. I mean, check this out. I can literally grab this picture from the Photos app, then use my thumb to bring up the dock, open a photo editing app like Affinity Photo, then drop it in, and bam! It's been transferred to the app, ready for me to edit. The Galaxy Tab just doesn't have that level of drag and drop ability. Don't get me wrong, it'll still get the job done for basic drag and drop stuff, but just nothing more advanced than that. When it comes to picture-in-picture, I think the Galaxy Tab has the slight edge here, at least for now. It has native support for all the popular apps like Netflix and YouTube, so you can continue to work while catching up on your favorite shows. The iPad Pro does picture-in-picture for pretty much everything except the YouTube app, which is so strange. The easiest workaround is to access YouTube.com through Safari, which does support picture-in-picture. But yeah, the YouTube app itself doesn't support it right now. What you can expect to work seamlessly on both, though, is a service from today's video sponsor, Surfshark VPN. What Surfshark does is that it encrypts all your data before it goes over the internet, so people you don't want having access to your personal information won't have access to it, especially relevant on sketchy public Wi-Fi. Being Canadian, one of my favorite uses for Surfshark is to access content from other countries. All it takes is one click, and I can discover new content from anywhere, including the US, UK, even Japan. What's great is that they don't limit the number of devices you can connect at a time. This means mom, dad, brother, sister, everyone in the family is secured. If this all sounds good, check out Surfshark now by clicking the link below and using my promo code TAO. You'll get 83% off and 3 months completely free. So, I mean, Apple's been working on perfecting their tablets for a while now, and I think the iPad Pro, as a tablet, offers a multitasking experience that's a little more fluid and refined. The attention to detail in the UI for iPadOS is seriously impressive, and that helps a lot when you're working across different apps. Although the Galaxy Tab might be a little rough around the edges, it's still a multitasking monster, giving you tons of freedom to work how you want. Samsung DeX and proper external monitor support are amazing features to have on a tablet, especially when it comes to productivity. Like always, your ecosystem of choice is gonna matter way more, but it's still fun to put two of the best head-to-head like this to see what they can possibly learn from each other. As usual, thank you so much for watching. Until the next one, I'm out of here. Yeah, I am on my way. I won't slow down.
I'm strolling down the street with all of my favorite songs on repeat. I'm dancing through.